from the Walt Disney World Resort in Florida. A Disney Christmas extravaganza with season's greetings to all of America, Canada, South America, Europe, and servicemen and women around the world. The all-new 1989 Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. Join our parade hosts, Mickey Mouse.
Hiya, folks.
Minnie Mouse.
Merry Christmas.
And the whole Disney gang. Along with Joan Lunden, Alan Thicke, Kermit the Frog, and Regis Philbin at Walt Disney World in Florida. Plus, from Disneyland in California, meet Growing Pains' Joanna, Kerns, Family Ties' Mark Price, and Major Dad's Whitney Kershaw for a coast-to-coast Disney Christmas celebration. Take a trip to a galaxy far, far away. Celebrate Christmas Disney style with the Mickey Mouse Club. Join a sun and sand Christmas vacation with Santa's Elves at Typhoon Lagoon. Come along with Kermit the Frog for a sleigh ride at the Disney MGM Studios theme park. Say hello to Ariel, the Little Mermaid. Celebrate Disneyland's 35th anniversary. And catch all the magic and excitement of an all-new Disney Christmas parade, packed with new floats, new music, and lots of new surprises. Now, let's go down to the Magic Kingdom as the University of Florida Gator Marching Band kicks off the festivities.
Everybody, I'm Joan Lunden.
Yes, happy holidays. I'm Alan Thicke, along with our parade co-hosts, Mickey and Minnie Mouse.
Yeah, they're going to be along in just a moment. We are here live in the Magic Kingdom in Florida, and really, you can feel the excitement in the air. Every Christmas morning, it's like this.
Yes, it's an all-new parade this year, too. Yeah. All of your favorite Disney characters.
Plus, lots of new surprises. And don't forget, we're also going to be visiting Disneyland in California for a celebration. So we want you to stay right where you are, because we will be back with all the Christmas Disney magic, and we are getting set for the biggest Disney Christmas celebration ever.
Santa's looking
That's
good.
That's right over here, please, a little bit. Yeah, there you go.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, brought to you by the Kissimmee-St. Cloud Resort Area, for the best room rates outside the gates of the Walt Disney World Vacation Kingdom. And Premier, the official cruise line of Walt Disney World, with the exclusive cruise and Disney Week.
1989 Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Yes, we're coming to you live from the Magic Kingdom.
And you know, this is actually the 7th annual Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Mm-hmm, but this year, all new music and new floats and, of course, handsome Prince Regis again.
Oh, that's right. Well, we shouldn't waste a moment. Let's go down to Main Street, USA and catch all the excitement with Regis Philbin. Hi, Reg.
Hey, thanks, Alan. Thanks, Joan. I'm here on Main Street, USA for the start of the big parade. And you can't believe how excited these folks are. Yeah, sure. They wouldn't miss being here on the Magic Kingdom on Christmas Day. Everybody having a wonderful time here in the sunshine, Walt Disney World. Now, I've just learned that some celebrities may be in the... You look familiar, but no celebrity. But anyway, maybe there is a celebrity here. Why, yes, look who's here. Ladies and gentlemen, what luck. Here's Kermit the Frog, everybody.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Merry,
Happy holidays.
Yes, and happy holidays to you too, Regis.
Welcome to Walt Disney World. Kermit, I understand that you and the Muppets will be coming here this spring.
Yeah, actually, this is going to be our new home down here.
Really? Will this be the first time you'll be at Walt Disney World?
Well, no, people don't realize it, but actually, we came close to working with Disney many times in the past.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah. You know, when they first did Sleeping Beauty, Miss Piggy was going to play the part.
Yeah.
But they couldn't get her to sit still and keep quiet.
I can imagine. Too bad about that.
Yeah, and then when they did Snow White, Gonzo had the part of one of the dwarves,
yeah.
But at the last minute, they cut the part of Smelly.
Cut the part of Smelly? What
yeah,
a shame.
Yeah.
Well, tell me, Kermit, what exactly will you and the Muppets be doing here at Walt Disney World?
Well, we're going to be at the Disney MGM Studios, and we're going to be making movies and putting on shows.
Things going smoothly?
They're just great. Mickey's been wonderful, and the only problem is that Miss Piggy has requested a particular dressing room.
Oh, really? Just like her? Well, what does she have in mind?
Well, she wants Cinderella's castle.
Yeah, well, good luck on that one, Kermit. Yeah.
Hey, well, listen, I got to be going, because I'm going to do a sleigh ride down at the studios. I'll see you later. Okay.
See you later, Kermit.
Okay.
Say goodbye to Kermit, everybody.
Bye.
What a crowd this is. Anyway, nice talking to Kermit. And wait a minute, what's this I hear? There is great music in the air, Christmas music, and that can mean only one thing. Here comes the all-new 1989 Walt Disney Very Merry Christmas Day Parade. Right over there, everybody. Hey!
And thank you, Regis. Thank you, Kermit. And here comes the parade, led by our two little elves, and who are those guys on horseback?
Well, those are the knights on horseback, of course, reminding us of the days of knights and the knights of days and the knights of chivalry. And, of course, they wore that armor and when they were first learning to ride in case they hit a tree.
Wait. They wore that when they went to battle.
Well, you might be right, but I don't have the facts. I just, you're here to keep me on track, Joan. They certainly look resplendent, I think. There's no arguing with that.
And all throughout this parade, you're going to be seeing costumes like that, many of them made right here. And what is it? Isn't it the largest costume department in the world?
This is, at Walt Disney World.
That world. Shot right now you're seeing down Main Street, USA. Our host of this parade.
Of course, the Lady Di and Prince Charles of Disney World.
No, Mickey Mouse and Minnie Mouse. And look who's there with them, my little Lindsay and Jamie. Are riding in the carriage with them. They're so excited about this.
Mickey and Minnie got top billing this year over your children.
I thought that would be a good idea.
What a thrill for them. And for all the kids lining the parade route this morning, what did you get Mickey for Christmas? What do you get a mouse for Christmas?
I don't know. What do you get a mouse for Christmas, Alan?
I didn't have the answer to that one either. Some cheese, I guess.
A quarter.
A carton of Camembert or put under their brie tree.
This is the band coming down Main Street right now, led by Major Mike Davis, who's, I think, been leading this parade every year for the last 7 years, I think.
He's getting good at it. Music adds the excitement, of course, for us every Christmas morning.
And I will tell you people at home that the folks down here visiting Disney World have been lined up out of the gate since I think 6 o'clock this morning, waiting to get in so that they could get their position right along the parade route that comes from Frontierland right down through Main Street. And it is quite a sight out there with all the garlands. And you see Cinderella's castle there at the back of Main Street.
Familiar Christmas carols in the background?
Now, this is Cinderella's court dancing group, which can only mean one thing, Alan.
Well, Cinderella must be nearby.
She can't be too far behind.
I got her some glass tennis shoes.
Did you? For anyone coming down here and going to the Disney MGM Studios theme park, you can now take a backstage tour, and you are taken right alongside the costume department, and you can see where a lot of these costumes are being sewn.
Yes.
Of course, Pearly and Susan, I imagine.
They do most
Pearly
of the work.
Yes. They had a little something
to do
with
these. The cold days making short jones for the dwarves.
There she is, Alan. Cinderella.
As beautiful as ever.
In her glass carriage. She is, of course, the reigning queen of the Magic Kingdom.
Now, Regis has a live, hard-hitting interview, I think, here with Cinderella. Regis?
Go ahead, Reg.
All right, Merry Christmas, Cinderella.
Merry Christmas, Regis.
You look absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, well, thank you very much. I'm having a wonderful time.
Well, I know you got to get back by midnight, right?
That's right, I do.
Bye-bye. Take care.
Merry Christmas. Christmas, everyone!
Ah, Merry Christmas to Cinderella. Did you know that her real name was Ella? But when she finished her chores, she would sit among all the chimney cinders to keep warm, so everyone just started calling her Cinderella.
You see the six small white ponies pulling that former pumpkin? You can hear the mini Winnie up here from those little guys. Beautiful character.
Ah, there's the handsome prince.
Standing guard this morning. Taking care of his lady.
And he would marry no one but the woman who fit that glass slipper.
Now, where's the fairy go?
There she is on the back of the coach.
Of course. She was the one who turned that pumpkin into a coach.
Now, the castle float is coming down Main Street right now.
And the royal guard, all decked out in blue.
Now, I believe that they are announcing the arrival of Sleeping Beauty.
Yes, even she couldn't sleep this morning with all the excitement on Christmas morning.
Yes, this is Sleeping Beauty's Royal Ice Palace there.
The tallest in the parade, Joan.
What is it, about 16, 17?
17 feet high,
so it just fits
palace.
Underneath all the garlands there.
Just barely. Not everyone was good to Cinderella. She has those...
The good fairies, huh?
Yes, the three good fairies. The step fairies raised her, and her name was Aurora, right?
That's right.
Sleeping Beauty.
They kept
raised
it out there in the forest all that time. There is so much color and excitement in this all-new parade. It's really great. A lot of things new this year.
Yes, and of course, everyone lives happily ever after at Disney World, as you can see, with most of our characters.
And this is the all-new Christmas parade this year, and it's just the beginning, though.
Yes, well, we have the trip to Typhoon Lagoon Park. Kermit the Frog is going to be over at the studio theme park, and the elves over
Absolutely.
At Typhoon Lagoon are on a well-deserved vacation.
So we'll be right back. Stay with us.
Coming up next, Alan travels to a galaxy far, far away and meets up with C-3PO and R2-D2. We'll be back in a moment.
We are coming to you live this Christmas morning from Walt Disney World in Florida.
And later on, we'll visit Disneyland in California for a coast-to-coast Disney Christmas celebration. Right now, still lots of excitement. You can hear it down on Main Street. Let's take a look.
Well, either I'm going Quackers or I can see DuckTales coming down Main Street.
No, you're right. That's Webigail Launchpad. Huey, Dewey, and Louie from DuckTales. Let's have a listen.
I would say that performance was just ducky, wouldn't you?
Yeah, well, as long as one of us says it.
All right, here come the characters from Pinocchio. Up there with Pinocchio, you'll see Geppetto, who, of course, always wished for a real boy to love and take care of.
Yes, but what about Stromboli? Remember that mean puppeteer who threw Pinocchio in a cage and wasn't going to let him out?
Well, yeah, unfortunately, though, Jiminy Cricket saved him, right?
Who have you got there? Foul Fellow.
They're all there. In fact, I think I see Foul Fellow and Gideon. They, of course, took Pinocchio off to an island and tried to turn him into a mule. Remember that?
Yes. But Pinocchio had to prove himself good and true if he wanted to become a real boy.
And Jiminy was always there to save him.
He's
there he is this morning.
Twice, want
to find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town.
He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good.
So be good for goodness sake.
Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. Better not fall. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
All right, Jiminy. Saved Pinocchio and his entire nose. And they lived happily ever after.
Pinocchio's a real favorite of all the kids out here.
Well, some great songs, too. Give a little whistle when you wish upon a star from that film. Christmas at Disney World. It's a tradition for us.
You bet it is.
Having fun this year?
I'm having a great time.
I sure am. I also had a pretty exciting trip earlier in my visit here.
Yes, and where might that have been?
Well, as you know, Walt Disney World is the world's number one vacation destination. Yeah. But did you know that very soon folks will be able to take off for galaxies far, far away on Star Tours? They'll leave from the Disney MGM Studios theme park right here at Walt Disney World. Now, Star Tours opens in January, but I said I knew Regis Philbin personally, and boom, VIP time. I got a sneak preview.
Star Tours Flight 1119, nonstop service to Endor, is now ready for boarding at gate number one. All passengers, please proceed to the boarding area immediately.
Hey! You there. Excuse me. Hello. I'm talking to you.
Talking to me?
Yes, you. Are you very mechanical?
No, you're mechanical. I'm human. And I came here for some R&R, and that's rest and relaxation, not repairs and remodeling.
Well, I was just wondering if you could tell me where this goes.
You try right in there.
Well, thanks for trying to help me out. You have a nice flight. I'll figure this out. Eventually.
I hope so. I'm getting a little nervous about this whole thing.
Attention, please. All droids leaving the system must be cleared by customs control.
That's us.
Required for all droids.
Stand by for final systems check. Forward lights. Check. Deflector shield. Check. Laser cannons. Check. Shut them down before you blow up the whole place.
Whoa. Hey, I don't know how far it is to Endor, but you kids are going to have some big-time frequent flyer miles.
Your attention, please. All interplanetary travelers must have a current passport and the necessary visas prior to leaving the space. Passengers requiring assistance.
Finally, a little rest and relaxation.
Thank you.
45, you're going the wrong way. Stop immediately.
R2, light speed to Endor!
Rig 24, I'm going in. Cover me.
Star Tours announces the cancellation of Flight 124.
Are we here?
Passengers holding confirmed tickets for Flight 124 should check with the
nearest
Star Tours
agent.
I
want to do it again.
Coming up, celebrate Christmas with Santa's Elves at Walt Disney World's spectacular new water park, Typhoon Lagoon, when the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade returns.
everyone to a spectacular Disney Christmas celebration, the Very Merry Christmas Parade, coming to you live from the Magic Kingdom in Florida.
And what a great place to celebrate the holidays. We've got lots more parade coming your way, but first, let's go back down to Main Street with Regis Philbin and see what's happening. Reed, you there?
Hey, thank you, Joan. Down here on Main Street, the crowd just loving this parade, right?
Yeah.
Buffalo Bills ball, everybody. And look at this guy right here. We've had some cold weather here in Florida. It's beginning to warm up, but this guy's overdoing it. How are you, Mr. Lynch?
Fine.
Yeah, nice to see you. Now, listen, everybody. Beginning next year, the folks in Epcot Center can actually vote for who they think the greatest person of the century was. Anybody from Einstein to Babe Ruth, all right? Now, who would you vote for?
Babe Ruth.
Babe Ruth, great. And you?
Me? Babe Ruth.
Yes, why did I say Babe Ruth? The greatest person of the century, lady.
Walt Disney.
Yay, that's what I was going to say.
All right, fine. In any event, here is the chairman of the Walt Disney Company, Michael Eisner, to tell you more about the person of the century.
Thank you, Regis, and Merry Christmas to one and all. I just want to take a few minutes this Christmas morning to tell you a little about what I believe is one of the most significant projects on which the Walt Disney Company has ever embarked. Beginning January 1st at the Epcot Pole and Epcot Center at Walt Disney World, we will begin asking you to vote for a person of the century, the person you feel has had the greatest impact on the 20th century. The balloting will continue through December 15th, 1999. Then on January 1st, the year 2000, at 12 noon in Epcot Center, I will have the honor of announcing the person of the century is elected by you. In addition, special Person of the Century honors will also be announced in the following categories: government, military, science, medicine, education, business, sports, entertainment, literature, and the arts. Much work on this project is already underway. You are looking at a list of nominees submitted by 2,500 universities around the world. The time, effort, and dedication the universities have expended is greatly appreciated. I will periodically report to you on the process and progress of this exciting, dramatic program. Be sure to watch for continuing information in magazines, on radio and television, and in your local newspapers. And most importantly, we want you to be a part of the Epcot Poll Person of the Century. I want to wish each and every one of you a most happy holiday season, and may the 90s be your best decade ever. And now, back to the Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Thank you, Michael Eisner, and thank you, Regis. Here comes the Calliope down Main Street. Look at that.
The Calliope was with Walt Disney on the opening day of Disneyland 35 years ago, before our time, Joan.
Next year,
Disneyland is celebrating their 35th anniversary with a giant party.
Now, if you see those guys kind of jiggling around up there, that thing has no spring, so they really know the meaning of Rough Rider.
Well, it was built in 1907, and Walt Disney saw it in the 40s and bought it. Just impulse buying.
Look who's there, Snow White and the gang.
Oh, yes, the fairest maiden of all.
Remember how Snow White's jealous stepmother sent her out into the forest to be killed? But then the kind woodsman set her free, and she found her little friends. Redeem yourself. Can you name them?
Everybody join us now with Frosty.
He's a jolly, happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal.
Hey!
Frosty the Snowman is a fairy tale, they say. He was made of snow, but the children know how he came to life one day.
There must have been some magic in that old silk hat they found.
Joe!
When they placed it on his head, he began to dance around.
Oh!
Frosty the Snowman was alive as he could be.
And the children say he could laugh and play just the same as you and me. Hey!
Thumpity, 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 thumpity.
Oh, this is fast.
Hey! I got the haze.
There she
is. Gonna melt singing it.
All right, now try it again. Can you name the seven dwarfs?
Of course. Well, I don't quite get it right, but this year maybe. Happy, Grumpy, Cranky, Funky, Curly, Larry, and LaToya.
No, Doc and Dopey, Grumpy, Happy.
Sleepy is
Sleepy
there.
Sleepy is there. Right there. And, of course, Snoopy and Bashful are out there as well.
I'll get him next year.
Look at that shot down Main Street. Dancing dwarfs.
What'll they think of next? You sounded pretty good with Frosty. You got that tall.
I'm gonna take a lot of sound. I'm sure I'll take a lot of ribbing for that later. Now here's one of my little Sarah's favorite, Winnie the Pooh.
And Tigger, too.
No one eats more honey than Pooh Bear, right?
It's a
sugar once for me?
Oh, we try at Christmas time.
In case you didn't hear.
Oh my God, have a holly jolly Christmas.
Now, the real name of Pooh, do you know that?
Grumpy.
Edward Bear. No, Pooh's never grumpy.
Holly jolly Christmas.
And his best friend is Tigger, who's right out there on the street with him. And Eeyore is also out there.
What about the owl?
I think the owl's up on the float. There's Kanga.
Yes.
With little wheels in his tummy.
His little pouch, that built-in car seat.
There's the owl right there.
And there's the owl, sure, looking wise and old. But dancing up a storm this Christmas morn.
And, of course, dancing trees just to round things off.
Everybody dances.
I heard a little boy saying, Daddy, how do they do that? Our tree doesn't dance. That's great.
Everyone having a good time here on Main Street.
And there's another group of folks who are having a good time today, too, Santa's elves. And now that Christmas Day is here, they've earned a little vacation. So let's join them at Walt Disney World's fabulous new water park, Typhoon Lagoon, for a sun, sand, and beach Christmas celebration. Watch.
Job is done.
We're in the pool.
The weather's warm, but we'll play it cool. We're on vacation. Having lots of fun.
V-A-C-A-T-I-O-N.
At Typhoon Lagoon.
We're gonna grab a bite at the ice cream stand.
Gosh, write love letters in the sand.
Oh, yes.
We're on vacation. Christmas Day is here.
B-A-C-A-T-I-O-N. Now it's Christmas time.
We'll splash splash together, but we want to go.
I never looked at the clock. We're gonna hug and kiss, just like this.
And I can't wait to go, go, go. We're gonna mash potato to a jukebox tune.
Hide behind a red balloon.
We're on vacation.
Gonna have a ball.
Stay tuned for a visit with the Little Mermaid, Flounder, Sebastian, and Ursula the Sea Witch when the Very Merry Christmas Parade continues. The World Very Merry Christmas Parade will continue in a moment.
And Merry Christmas, everybody. Welcome back to live to the Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Yes, and here at Disney World, we have mice, we have ducks, and this year we have frogs, the most famous frog of all, Kermit the Frog, and he's going to be taking us on a sleigh ride through the Disney MGM Studios theme park.
But right now, we have a lot more Christmas parade for you, so let's go back down to Main Street and celebrate a riverboat Christmas. And there it is, coming down Main Street, USA.
Gigantic riverboat. People with some very talented musicians. They're actually students who perform here at the Magic Kingdom during Christmas time.
Duck himself, Donald, along with his lovely lady, Daisy.
What is a famous duck do at a banquet? You suppose the ducks eat the chicken?
Oh, boo.
No turkey for them on Christmas.
Country Bears coming up to
yes,
Main Street, right?
Country Christmas time.
You know
with
who
Wendell,
they are?
Liver Lips and Shaker.
Very good, Alan.
My
Those
lawyer.
Country Bears, they perform every day in the Magic Kingdom over in Frontierland called the Country Bear Hoedown.
Mm-hmm. Now, these are non-hibernating bears, of course.
That's right. When they live in Florida, they just perform all year long because it's always warm here.
Mm-hmm. And if you watch closely, you'll see scarecrows and cloggers. Country girls all celebrating a country Christmas. Let's look.
Down there on the streets.
Oh, must be exhausted. Great parade. We have the best seat in the house.
Yeah,
hope everything
really
is well at your house. Stay tuned also because you'll be getting a visit from the big guy himself.
That's right, Santa Claus. But right now, we are about to meet the newest girl in a long line of Disney's classic animated female characters, also the people who created her. Her name is Ariel, and she's just a little doll, or should I say, a little mermaid.
I want to be where the people are. I want to see... Wanna see them dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh, feet.
On this film, I think I grew as an artist more than I have in any film. Just trying to draw the character so she looks pretty. I mean, that's a tough thing just in itself. And, you know, if you draw her jaw just a little too big, she looks like Jay Leno or something, you know. And then the other side of it was the character was so expressive that we couldn't just go for pretty. We had to go for real.
First, our initial approach to her was something like the fairy tale in that she was sort of very quiet, shy, strong-willed, but fairly reserved. And then as we started picturing her in animation, we started pushing her completely sort of in the other direction, and we made her more feisty, strong-willed, more stubborn sort of personality. She argues with her father. She goes off in pursuit of her goal against her father's wishes. She strikes a deal with the Sea Witch. She puts her own name on the dotted line. She basically makes these conscious choices.
And we videotaped Jodie Benson singing Part of Your World, and you could really just see what was the most appealing part of her performance there was her eyes. I mean, she was just believing what she was singing about.
She's just got her own kind of personality. She definitely stands on her own two feet, or her own two fins, I guess. She's neat. I really like her.
Then, so we brought Sherry in to act out the movements to Jodie's recording, to see what it was we were trying to get in the performance.
For Part of Your World, Glenn, he knew exactly what he wanted. You know, he had it in his mind. He knew what he wanted from the scene, I could tell. And so he told me what to do, and he would show me sometimes. He would go, okay, you're laying on the rock, and then you use your arms, you know, and you move up like this, and it's a very important moment for you. And I'd watch him, and I'd say, gosh, you're Ariel, you know?
And then she would come up with something totally different and fresh, and you realize so much better than I ever could have thought of.
I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty.
So I spent a lot of time looking at these photostats of Sherry and trying to capture that in my drawing. And it's not a thing where, like, you could trace it.
Because that seemed to be a real concern. There's more so than just movement, because obviously they are talented enough to draw a girl moving or a mermaid moving. They really wanted a sense of truth to her.
So you realize, all right, now how do I get that feeling into it? And you started just experimenting, pushing shapes around, exaggerating different parts of the face, till you can capture this feeling that's up there.
I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's it's and what's it's galore. You want thingamabobs? I got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more.
So I did have a very strong sense of who she was and what she was. She was part animal, so there's an innocence there that goes beyond a human innocence. I thought it's a true wonderment with the world.
When we were making the film, we conceived it really with ourselves as the audience, and we never thought while we were making it to you, will the kids understand this or not? We tried to take a simple story and tell it entertainingly with appealing characters, which is sort of the foundation of the classic Disney animated films.
It moves me to see how well their efforts paid off. It's really something very special.
And coming down the street now, for a Caribbean Christmas.
Or a Caribbean.
Tomato, tomato.
That's Ariel herself right there, the Little Mermaid. Look at Sebastian up there, the nicest crab you'll ever meet. Little Flounder, he's
flounder.
So cute. Look at him jump. A jumping fish.
Little Mermaid, a classic already. What about the lucky prince who won Ariel?
He's over there on the other side, yes, absolutely.
Prince Eric. There's already a Prince Charming, so he would be what? Prince Personable. Prince Gregarious. Uh-oh.
Oh, there's Ursula, the sea witch, who made Ariel a real girl, but in exchange for her beautiful voice.
That's a hard bargain.
Can you tell that I've seen this movie many times already?
Remember, kids, never play poker with an octopus, because when they get a great hand, you're dead.
This, of course, was a wonderful story to begin with by Hans Christian Andersen. And people are enjoying it. We'll have more of the Very Merry Christmas Parade live from the Magic Kingdom in Disney World in just a moment.
That is a cute clown.
Stay right where you are. We'll be back with Chip and Dale's Rescue Rangers and Gummy Bears when the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade continues.
We're coming to you live from the Magic Kingdom in Florida, having a great time, as you can see. Folks here lining Main Street, USA to enjoy this very Merry Christmas Parade. And they're from all over the world, right? Yeah, where are you from, pal?
Buffalo, New York.
Marblehead, Mass.
Marblehead.
Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Come a long way. And what is your favorite ride here?
Space Mountain.
Don't you get a little frightened up there?
Yes, but it's great.
All alone in the inky blackness? You never know. Mm-hmm. Come out of the wall. And what about your favorite ride?
Space Mountain. I'm fine. How are you doing? I'm from St. Louis, Missouri.
Got a good gang here. Yeah, they're all over the place. How about you? Where are you from?
Ocean City, Maryland.
What's your favorite ride?
Space Mountain.
Yeah, that seems to be everybody's favorite ride. All right, well now, keep going. Sure. Yes, ma'am. How are you?
I'm from New Rochelle.
New Rochelle, New York. Yeah, and you?
Hi, Erie, Pennsylvania.
You got a favorite ride here other than Space Mountain?
Big Thunder Mountain.
Any mountain will do. All right, right now, let's go back to the parade and join those adventurous chipmunks, Chip and Dale, the Rescue Rangers.
Well, thank you, Regis, and look who's writing on the front of the toy factory. It's Gadget, a self-taught mouse inventor who, true to her name, can make practically anything out of practically nothing.
Made a pretty good scene for herself up top there.
Certainly did. Tiny train pulling.
That was a little engine that could.
That you better believe it.
And had a hernia in the process.
Hey, Gadget.
Now that RR, of course, stands for Rest in relaxation?
Yes. No. The Rescue Rangers. And I hear them back there. And now we see them. Little Chip and Dale. Do you know how to tell them apart?
Chip and Dale?
Yes.
Well, Chip is the more organized and pragmatic.
Yes, and Chip also has one tooth and Dale has two. Oh,
Chip
look at
has
there,
a
raggedy Ann. My little Sarah just got a raggedy Ann doll. And straight from the jungle, the monkeys. That means King Lion is out there.
There he is.
Mr. and Mrs. Teddy Bear. Maybe Teddy and Teddita.
A lot of bears here today, including...
All right, you missed it on the Seven Dwarfs. You can redeem yourself now. Name the gummy bears.
Name the gummy bears. Of course, there was Sneezy and Sloppy and Crummy Gummy. No, no, that would be Harpo Chico, Charo Comet, Cupid, Squeamish,
Cubby,
and Bow.
Grammy, Gruffy, Sunny, Tummy, and Zummy, of course.
Yes. And watch out for Mr. Sweet Tooth, or you become a dummy gummy, a yummy gummy.
A yummy gummy.
Donner, Blitzen.
Look at the pretty little doll in the toy factory. Lots of little dolls were presents this Christmas day.
Lots of toys, of course. That time of year when Dad gathers the kids around the tree and says, we're broke.
You could give gummy bears to the gummy bears.
The only thing brighter than the costumes and floats, I think, are the faces of those kids watching
the parade. And Cinderella's castle is up at one end of the main street. Down at the other end is that huge, gigantic Christmas tree that they get out there and decorate every year.
Mm-hmm. Big lantern. Terrific parade today. Hope you're having fun.
We're having a terrific time. But just the other day, I had a chance to ride Body Wars. And it's a great new attraction over at Epcot Center's new pavilion, Wonders of Life. Body Wars is a great ride through the human body.
Yeah, but with all due respect, Joan, of course, you've lost a lot of weight this past, but still you're a size large maybe to go through a human body.
The secret is miniaturization. Watch.
Who's gonna go in first, huh? It says Wonders of Life. Come on. Wow, what a great place. Look at that. Okay, everybody hold hands. All right, now you guys, we're going to get miniaturized.
What does miniaturize mean?
That means they're gonna make us so tiny that we can actually travel through a human body.
Attention, to miniaturization now commencing.
Wow, that was great. What do you say we ride this one again, huh, kids?
Yeah!
Well, that's a great trick, ladies and gentlemen. Joan Lunden miniaturized. How did that feel? Joan? Joan? Where are you?
Hi, Joan? Alan. Joan? I'm down here.
Honey, I shrunk Joan Lunden. Joan, you said you wanted to lose weight, not height. Come on, come back and be your tall self. Joan.
What's the matter? I had a great time.
I'm so glad to see you back. And there will be more great times ahead because we have lots of parade, lots of fun coming up. But don't ever do that again.
That was so much
fun,
though.
You had me worried sick.
Oh,
you're grounded.
I'm sorry.
You are grounded. I'm taking back that nice tie I got you and everything.
We'll be back.
Next, everybody's favorite amphibian, Kermit the Frog, at the Disney MGM Studios theme park. We'll be right back. The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, brought to you by Premier, the official cruise line of Walt Disney World, with the exclusive cruise and Disney Week, and the Kissimmee St. Cloud Resort area, for the best room rates outside the gates of the Walt Disney World Vacation Kingdom.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. Merry Christmas to you and your family. You have family here?
Yes, Michael and the girls will be along later to help us close out the show.
But is there anyone okay?
Yeah, I'd like to say Merry Christmas to my mom, Gladys, out in California, my brother Jeff. Mm-hmm. Can't be with him.
And
how about your family?
Well, my grandparents, Izzy and Willis Greer, are about as far away as you can get and still receive a TV signal way up in northern Canada. So especially.
And your boys just went back out to California. So.
My boys are stuffing turkeys right now.
But we are coming to you today live from the Magic Kingdom in Florida. We've had a great time so far. There's of course lots more parade coming your way.
And we'll be visiting Disneyland with my personal favorite
your other
TV
family.
Wife, yes, Mrs. Seaver, Growing Pains, lovely and talented Joanna Kerns. Also Family Ties, Mark Price, Major Dad's Whitney Kershaw. That's for a Disneyland Christmas celebration. But right now, more music on Main Street. I can hear it. Let's go down and join you.
Yep, there we are. The Fighting Wildcats marching band from Bethune-Cookman College in Daytona Beach, Florida.
The Fighting Wildcats performing under the direction of their musical director, Harold Bray.
Let's listen.
That street.
The lovable pooch Pluto. Mm-hmm. I guess if a dog is a man's best friend, then Pluto is a mouse's best friend. He's always loyal to Mickey and Minnie.
You got that toy train chugging along behind him.
He's got his bone in his hand, but his real reward would be a hug from Mickey.
How would that be?
Who's back there? Oh, I can tell by the ears flopping.
I'm sorry, I don't do rabbits, but Roger's here.
That pretty good. Trainer, really cool. Love, smoke that blows, and I'm all wood. And look who's driving there. It's Goofy.
I wish he'd use two hands conducting that train.
Well, he's all bumbling his way in and out of situations, but he seems to be keeping it in tow there.
Hey, get those clowns off the parade.
All right, this silly group of clowns is actually comprised of, once again, student musicians. And as you know, Alan, many kids get their first taste of performing in front of guests, you know, right here at Walt Disney World.
I hope their families back home can recognize them under that makeup. Hi, Mom.
Well, she found someone out there in the audience. Uh-oh.
Don't let that audience
Uh-oh.
Participation.
They've got people up off the streets dancing this morning. Oh, big toy blocks there.
Toy blocks coming down the street. Size of a city block, big toy blocks.
We've got a very special guest, though, that I know a lot of you have been waiting for, and that is Kermit the Frog, a new face in the Disney family, but a very old friend, of course, to all of us who either grew up on Sesame Street or whose children did, like mine.
Kermit and his Muppet friends will be making their home here, beginning this summer, over at Disney MGM Studios theme park. There'll be a fabulous stage show and parade, and later, a 3D Muppet movie. So let's visit Kermit there for a Christmas sleigh ride.
What a neat place to be at Christmas, the Disney MGM Studios. You know, I have a feeling this is not the regular studio tram. Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling, yoo-hoo! Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Giddy-up, 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 let's go! Let's go!
holding her hand.
We're gliding along with the song of a witch big fairyland. Our cheeks are nice and rosy and comfy cozy are we.
We're snuggled up together like two birds of a feather should be.
Let's take that road before us and sing a chorus or two.
Come on, it's lovely weather for us, let's ride together with you. Can't think of a better way to celebrate Christmas. A sleigh ride with two beautiful girls. All that's missing is the snow. Wait a second. This is a movie studio, right? Down here they can make dreams come true.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas,
just like the ones I used to know,
where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas with every Christmas card I write. May your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white.
It's like they say, there's no business like snow business. Everybody.
We'll be back in a moment with a coast-to-coast Christmas celebration from Disneyland in California. The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade will continue in a moment.
Welcome back to the Very Merry Christmas Parade. We are here at Walt Disney World, but in just a few minutes, we're going to be heading to California for a Disneyland Christmas extravaganza.
That's right. Lots more parade coming up here in the Magic Kingdom, including a Christmas Day appearance by Santa Claus, of course, and a visit with the Mouseketeers.
Now, right now, Disneyland is about to enjoy their biggest birthday celebration ever with an all-new parade called Party Gras, plus prizes galore for all the lucky guests. So beginning January 1st, everyone's invited to join the fun. And let's turn now to Disneyland in California, where all the Disney magic began almost 35 years ago, and see their Christmas celebration.
Yes, you're going to be hosted there by my very favorite TV wife, my only TV wife, Joanna Kerns from Growing Pains. She's there just 3,000 miles away, separated on Christmas morning. But Merry Christmas to you, Joanna.
Merry Christmas, Joanna.
Thanks, Joan. And thank you, Alan. And a very Merry Christmas to all of you at home. It's beautiful here at Disneyland in California, and I couldn't think of a more wonderful place to spend my Christmas. Disneyland has a very special birthday coming up, you know.
And to help us celebrate, here's Major Dad's Whitney Kershaw.
35 years old.
What started as a dream with one man's wish upon a star now keeps the whole world always dreaming. Just leave your cares outside the gate, come on in and celebrate. Soon the kid in you is singing.
Come on, celebrate Disneyland, 35 years young.
We can watch that star keep rising. Oh,
come on, celebrate Disneyland, 35 years young.
35 years young.
Join in, don't hesitate, clap your hands. Come and join the party and celebrate.
Everybody's looking forward, anticipation's high.
Here come the 90s, don't let them pass you by. The future's here at Disneyland, the biggest celebration.
Come on, celebrate Disneyland, 35 years young.
For nearly 35 years, guests from all over the world have been enjoying this park's special kind of magic. And 1990 is the biggest year for Disneyland yet. The holidays really are special here, with festive decorations everywhere. And in Town Square, there's a beautiful 50-foot Christmas tree. It really puts you in the holiday spirit. Let's go down to Main Street and join my co-host. He's a busy, talented man around town. He's got an ABC afternoon special coming up in January. And he's the star of the new Teen Win, Lose or Draw on the Disney Channel. But you know him best as Skippy from Family Ties, Mark Price. Hi, Mark. Is everyone having a good time?
Are we having a good time, Joanna? That is an understatement. Guys, what kind of time are we having? Yeah! We're having a time here on Main Street, USA, waiting for the parade to begin. The tension is building. And you know what I'm going to do here? These people don't even know it. I'm going to sneak off before the park even opens, and I am going to ride Splash Mountain first. I'm going to be the first person. That is cool, isn't it? Have you guys ridden Splash Mountain?
Yeah!
What was your favorite part?
When the bear had a honey bee on his head and all the bees on his head.
And then you go like that?
Keep going until finally you go up this huge hill, and then you see vultures, and then you go down like.
I gotta check this out. Here, hold that.
Now back to you, Joanna.
Yeah! It looks like I've got a new partner. Better watch out, Mark. Christmas at Disneyland is a family tradition for most of us in Southern California. And as a matter of fact, my daughter Ashley is enjoying Disneyland today while I work. Now, how does she always get to do that? Well, I hear the sounds of a marching band, and that could mean only one thing. Disneyland's Very Merry Christmas Parade has stepped off and is making its way toward Main Street. Back with us for a second straight year is the University of Southern California Trojan Marching Band. This award-winning band, under the direction of Dr. Arthur C. Bartner, has performed all over the world. Members, they nearly fill the entire length of Disneyland's Main Street. And following a marching band, what could be more suitable than marching elephants? It's Colonel Hattie and the Dawn Patrol, of course, from the Jungle Book. That's quite a dancer. And in front are Mowgli, the Lost Boy of the Jungle, and Baloo the Bear. On Rudyard Kipling's Stories of India, Jungle Book brings some pretty remarkable characters to life. These don't look like very ferocious hunters to me. They're having too good a time out there. Well, let's not forget King Louie and his monkey subjects. I wonder if he has trouble buying shirts. With arms like that, he must be hard to fit. Oh, I know, Alan. I probably shocked you with my singing, but it's become something of a joke on the Growing Pains set. But that song is the theme song of the Chimney Sweeps Everywhere, at least the sweeps from Mary Poppins, one of my favorite movies. Can't you imagine those sweeps dancing on your roof? Let's take a break from our parade on Main Street and see what Mark Price is up to at Splash Mountain. Mark?
Neil Armstrong was the first person to walk on the moon. I, Mark Price, am going to be the first person to ride Splash Mountain today. Oh, no! Well, here goes. One small step for a man, one giant step to get out of the way!
Now, it looks like Mark's about to take a plunge. Our parade from Disneyland is off and running, and there's still more to come, including a sneak peek at some exciting new plans for the biggest party in the history of Disneyland as the Magic Kingdom turns 35 years old. All of this when we return.
Coming up next, Peter Pan, Wendy, and Alice in Wonderland, when the Very Merry Christmas Parade continues. The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade will continue in a moment.
Welcome back, and it's exciting to see people from all over the world spending their Christmas at Disneyland. And for some, it's a family tradition year after year. And as Disneyland approaches its 35th birthday, plans are already afoot for a year-long celebration. There's new entertainment throughout the park, and a special new parade called Party Gras, which is Disneyland's biggest parade in 35 years. And when I say big, I mean Disneyland big. We've been real sneaky with our cameras, and we have a little surprise.
Oh my gosh! It's just a bird! It's a dog! It's Pluto!
Right you are, Mark. That is one big dog. Towering 40 feet over Main Street, Pluto the pup is just one of the Disney family who will be part of the big celebration next year.
Insane. Joanne, it's official now. The Party Gras Parade is a colossal event. It's overwhelming. It's humongous. It's gigantic. It's elephantine. That's what it is. It's big.
We've got a couple more 35th anniversary surprises for you, but first, let's get back to the Very Merry Christmas Parade. And away we go into Never Never Land with Peter Pan. There's Wendy and the Lost Boys and Michael and John. Aren't they cute? Peter Pan, as we all know, is the delightful story of a young boy who refuses to grow up. Now, I've known a few of those. Look out, Captain Hook. Look out, that crocodile has a taste for pirate. Keep rowing, Mr. Smee. If you listen closely, you just might hear the clock that Captain Hook threw into the crocodile's mouth. Can you hear it? There it is. Watch out, Peter. Those swashbuckling pirates are after you. But I'm not worried. I know Peter Pan can handle it. Oops, there he goes over the top. Ah! See, he's tied them all up single-handedly. Looks like we're off to Wonderland, and see, we're being greeted by Her Royal Highness herself, the Queen of Hearts, and her playing card henchman. This is a woman with a great sense of humor. Look at that smile. My favorite thing about the Queen is her croquet mallet, because if you look very closely, the mallet is actually a flamingo. Off with his head, you say. Now, right behind the Queen there, you will see white roses. Now, if I remember correctly, the Queen of Hearts ordered them painted red. What a job that must have been. We've all been invited to a mad tea party with Alice, the March Hare, and of course, the Mad Hatter. And behind Alice, we see tiger lilies and snapdragons. Where but in Wonderland will you find a pipe-smoking caterpillar? Oh, Mr. Caterpillar, don't you know that smoking is hazardous to your health? Look at those butterflies. Aren't they beautiful? Looks a little bit like a snob to me.
I hope all of you at home are enjoying the parade at Disneyland as much as I am.
And there's more to come when we return.
They run away and leave the sky.
We'll be back with more fun, including dancing hippos and giant ostriches, when the Very Merry Christmas Parade continues.
Thank you.
Some of the snacks you can buy at SeaWorld are so good.
Yeah.
You'll want to share them with a friend. Visit our dolphin feeding pool.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade will continue in a moment.
We've got a lot of wonderful entertainment still coming from Disneyland, so let's get back to the parade. If dancing hippos, ostriches, and crocodiles are your fancy, you're probably a fan of the film Fantasia. Not only is 1990 an important year for Disneyland, but it's a big one for this famous animated feature. It's hard to believe that next year Fantasia will be 50 years old. Based on 7 pieces of classical music, Fantasia was the first motion picture to record in stereophonic sound. Quite an innovation for 1940. And with skating snowflakes and snow people, I can see our parade has reached its finale. Disney's Very Merry Christmas Parade has thrilled millions of guests and become a Southern California tradition since its beginning in 1955. It's one of Disneyland's most special parades, bringing to life the fantasy of Disney characters from the classic animated films. The famous skating penguins having a great time on their very own Disney-styled skating rink. Disneyland has a very special birthday coming up, you know. In 1990, Disneyland will be 35 years old, and I feel right at home here. Now, you may not know this, Alan, but I performed here at Disneyland early on in my career. Now, the show was called The Great American Music Machine, and I was a backup dancer for great groups like The Temptations and The Righteous Brothers. But the most wonderful memory I have is of my costume, which was baby blue satin bell-bottoms and a rainbow-colored Afro wig. Now, what a memory that is. Now, a lot of people have fond recollection of Disneyland over the years, and I am one of them. It's truly a land of a million memories.
Welcome. I guess you all know this little fella here. It's an old partnership. Mickey and I started out the first time many, many years ago. We've had a lot of our dreams come true. Now we want you to share with us our latest and greatest dream. That's it, right here. Disneyland.
Some kind of an amusement enterprise built where that the parents and the children could have fun together.
Hope that we never lose sight of one thing, that it was all started by a mountain.
35 years of dreams coming true. Happy birthday, Disneyland. Great, but you know what time it is now?
Yes, it's time to get Whitney Kershaw's phone number. It's time to party at Disneyland! Come on, celebrate Disneyland!
Mark, that's next year. Right now, it's time to go back to Joan Lunden and my dear friend Alan Thicke for more Christmas fun at Walt Disney World.
Well, let's not leave out Regis Philbin.
Oh, yes, hi, Regis.
All right, everybody, from all of us here,
Merry Christmas from Disneyland!
Stay tuned for lots more Christmas fun, including a visit with the Mouseketeers, when the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade continues.
Welcome back, everyone, to the 1989 Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, live from the Magic Kingdom in Florida. It looked like Joanna and Mark and Whitney were having a great time out there in Disneyland, aren't they?
Oh, yes, but we have plenty more here. We got the big finale coming up with Santa Claus himself, so you better watch out and you better stay tuned and don't even go to the refrigerator and have a glass of milk.
A Christmas rendition.
Reindeer and the whole nine
from
yards.
From Alan Thicke. We want to introduce you right now, though, to some very talented kids, not the one that's next to me. The Mouseketeers from the Disney Channel's Mickey Mouse Club.
Oh, yes. I remember the Mickey Mouse Club. Love them. Mouseketeers never age. Did you know that?
Yeah, but this is a whole new group of kids. Over 5,000 kids from all over the country auditioned for just 14 spots. So this is really the creme de la creme.
Yes, and they have special talents. They sing and they dance. They act. Some of them even juggle. But mostly, they all look young like Mickey. It's the Dick Clark Club.
I took my girls over to a taping of the show, and they really had a good time. And this is a terrific, rousing Christmas rendition in the streets. Let's listen.
Dude in the red.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the one with the ho-ho-ho and the flying red sled.
I like that guy.
I know, Albert,
he is all right. As a matter of fact, he's coming down the chimney tonight.
Tonight?
So you better watch out.
And you better be good.
Yes, because he is watching everybody in the neighborhood. You know what I mean?
And do you fellas know why?
Why?
Because Santa Claus is coming to town, and he is not messing around.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Kids. Thank you, Mouseketeers.
As good as ever.
You bet. Here come the toy soldiers from Babes in Toyland.
Uh-huh. 32 of them there are, actually 16 in the regular marching corps and 16 in the band. The March of the Wooden Soldiers.
Babes in Toyland was first released at Christmas time in 1961, and it starred Ray Bolger and that very famous Mouseketeer, Alan.
I bet I know. That would be Annette.
Yes, Annette Funicello.
Yes. I was a boy. She was the main reason we all wanted to be a man.
That's right. Did you have a crush?
I had a major, yes. Everybody kind of did.
Well, every red-blooded boy in America, I think, was in love with Annette. And, of course, every kid in America is in love with Santa Claus, and he's going to be coming up next.
Oh, yeah. So you better stay tuned and you better look out and you better... Right in step, and the beautiful Florida sunshine bouncing off those toy soldiers' uniforms.
And lest anyone think that they are just marching to music, the toy soldiers are actually playing the horns.
Stuff.
And the drums. No, yes, they really are.
Oh, you better keep playing and you better keep playing. You know what's kind of sad about today? It's the end of the Christmas carol season.
Oh, I know.
Look forward to those every year. They're gone.
And as the temperature is rising down here in Florida, you can see people are peeling off the coats and the scarves.
Those people from Buffalo. they brought a suitcase to the parade.
For everyone who's watched this parade over the years, this is the seventh Christmas parade that we've done down here. And this is a brand new parade, 2 dozen new floats this year. And of course, appearances once again by all the Disney favorites, including the toy soldiers. I think I saw some toy blocks back there, too.
I saw a duck hat. I saw some toy blocks.
And we'll be back with lots more of the 1989 Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade in just a moment, so stay tuned.
Coming up next, a spectacular Christmas finale, including a visit with Santa Claus, when the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade continues.
Welcome back live to the grand finale of the Very Merry Christmas Parade. This is the moment that everyone has been waiting for.
Yes, my rap version of the Little Drummer Boy.
No, it's because Santa's on his way. Santa's on his way.
Here, yes.
But first, we've got dancing Christmas trees, gingerbread men, even an appearance by Mrs. Claus. She has to have a lot of patience this time of year.
Oh, we have to. Let's get down to Main Street then for the spectacular finale of this Very Merry Christmas Parade.
You got a sweet tooth, Alan?
Oh, you know, with those big candy canes at this time of year. If it weren't for candy, of course, dentists wouldn't have condos, though.
Well, no condo here. This is a yummy gingerbread house coming down Main Street. And a very important person lives there, Santa Claus. So who's out front there? Mrs. Claus.
Happy to have Santa home for another year. She snuck a cookie, I'm sure.
I think you're right. I think she's sneaking the cookie.
Well, she had the recipe. She knows how good they are. Surrounded by the Christmas elves. It's by Elves Presley.
Oh.
I'm sorry. It's Christmas. We have to be charitable. Mrs. Claus.
Behind every good man is a good woman, right? And there's Mrs. Claus. Did you see those? She had on Mickey Mouse earmuffs.
Those ears.
Those are mouse ears. Here are the rocking horses.
Watch closely and you'll see many of your favorite characters.
Oh, here comes the whole Robin Hood crew.
Maid Marian.
Robin Hood, of course, stole from the rich to give to the poor.
Yes.
Here are the three little pigs. The three little pigs. Can you name them?
Can I name the three little pigs? Sleepy, Weepy, Creepy.
No, Pfeiffer, Fiddler,
Weenie,
Practical.
Millie, Vanilli, and Chuck. Pfeiffer Pig was one of them.
Pfeiffer,
and Practical,
yes.
Pig, he would have been the one who built the brick house.
That's right. And those are some relatives of Donald's in there. That's Gladstone Gander and Grandma Duck.
And the dancing Christmas trees. Along with that huge gingerbread. Look at that.
Yeah. One of the biggest gingerbread men I've ever seen.
Baked by Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Did you know it was the very first Christmas tree in 1605 in Strasbourg, Germany, that they started the tradition of all of the decorations on it?
That's an obscure fact.
Yeah.
Okay, when was the second one?
The next Christmas.
That's super trivial. Wave at the ducks. Ducks for days and then, oh, look at them.
Oh, look at the faces on the children when all these characters come down the street.
the parents, I think it makes the whole trip worthwhile. If you're coming all the way from Winnipeg to Florida to get your little girl out there on the sidewalk and see her face light up at the sight of this wonderful parade. Makes a Merry Christmas for everybody.
Makes all the books and today all the videotapes come to life. Yeah. Christmas Day.
A little assembly required, they always said.
Christmas Day is always filled with a lot of magic and joy, Alan.
Yes, and mystery, of course.
That's right. Mystery about the man in that red and white suit, Santa Claus.
Well, Kermit has the story behind the Claus man. Take it away, Kermit.
Okay, thank you very much, Alan. Now, we do have some Santa Claus experts down here on the street, and we're going to ask a few questions about Santa Claus because these guys know about him more than anybody, you know? Tell me now, do you guys know what Santa Claus looks like?
Yeah!
Okay, and what does he look like?
White beard and
red suit. Red suit, yeah, all that stuff.
White belt.
What's that, Jill?
He's
got a hat on top of his head, and he's got a white beard. Hey, did you guys see that? Did Santa Claus come and bring you presents this morning?
Yeah!
Really? Oh, boy.
Okay. I got gold beard.
What?
I got gold beard.
Did you really? That was a present this morning?
Yeah.
Do you guys know the names of Santa Claus's reindeer?
Yeah!
Okay, well, what name some reindeer?
Rudolph.
Thunder,
Vixen.
Charlie, is that one of the reindeer?
Comet.
Charlie is not one of the reindeer, no. What?
Comet.
Charlie.
No, okay.
Cupid,
yeah, that's it.
Comet.
Yeah, you got a Barbie too?
Comet.
Yeah. No, Barbie is not one of the reindeer. Anyhow, I think we do have some wonderful experts on Santa Claus, so back to you.
Thank you, Kermit. Thanks, kids. Dancing reindeer are here. That means Santa Claus can't be far behind.
Can you name the reindeer, Alan?
The reindeer. That would be Rocky, Muffy, Judy.
Right. I see Rudolph there with the red nose.
Uh-huh. Have you been naughty or nice this year? I'm kind of hoping that Santa has me on a list that's somewhere in between. You know, maybe just nice with flurries of naughtiness, maybe. It's tough to get into that nice category for a whole year at a time. There are the Glockenspiel girls.
They're called the Glock girls because, of course, their instruments are called Glockenspiels. That's a fun word to say, Glockenspiels.
So there you have Glocky,
and there's Regis down there. Hi, Regis. How you doing, Regis?
Hi, Joan. How you doing?
Great.
I got him right up here, Santa Claus.
Oh,
yeah, he just got back traveling all night, but he still found time to come here to Disney World. I'm going to try to get... Hey, Santa Claus! Hey, Santa Claus! Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas to you, Regis.
And next year, Santa, I want what Alan Thicke got this year.
Well, I'll do my best for you, Regis,
my
friend.
All right, he says he'll do his best, but don't know. I ask every year to give you what
Merry
Alan Thicke got the year
before. Merry Christmas, everyone.
How are you? Anyway, it's a lovely
so good
setting
to see
down
all
here.
Of my friends
Santa
here.
Claus is up there. What could be better than this on Christmas morning here at Disney World?
Hello, everyone.
And now back to you, Alan
Have
and
you
Joan.
Been enjoying?
That's what we've been waiting for, the appearance by Santa Claus, who's got to be one mighty tired gentleman this morning.
Well, it's been a busy year for him, but he's looking good. He wasn't on that Joan Lunden diet, it doesn't look like.
He's been a little busy. Going all around the world, of course, we have people watching this program this morning from, I don't know, all over the world. We send our warmest Christmas wishes to them.
If Santa could just satellite himself up.
That's right. It's going to be a lot
easier night.
Yeah, look at all the folks in the crowd.
Certainly part of the magic of Christmas for all the boys and girls. That's what Santa Claus represents. The magic of Disney World has gotten to us once again, hasn't it?
You better believe it.
I've loved it.
We should say thank you to Regis, who's been down on the street all day. And, of course, thank you, Santa Claus.
And a real Merry Christmas to not only Santa and Regis, but to all of you folks at home. We hope you have a wonderful holiday season, a wonderful 1990, and a great decade for that matter.
You bet. And, you know, Epcot Center's showcase stands as a symbol here in Disney World of international understanding. And here, then, Christmas wishes from all around the world, starting with President Bush.
Good morning, and a Merry Christmas to everyone watching the wonderful World of Disney Parade.
Barbara and the whole Bush family, join me in sending our warmest Christmas wishes on this very special morning. I've long felt that Christmas is the most wonderful time of the year, a time of quiet fires warming a house, candlelight, and gloriously decorated Christmas trees. And it's also a time for family and friends to gather and rejoice in all the blessings we enjoy here at home. But Christmas is also a time to count the blessings closer to home and right across the table. As we share this day with our loved ones, as we see the sparkle in our children's and grandchildren's eyes and gather around the tree, let's remember that our family is the true blessing we celebrate this Christmas. And as we celebrate, let's make sure to remember those less fortunate. Reach out to those neighbors in your community who may need a hand this holiday season. Not only will their lives be enriched, but so will yours. Barbara joins me in sending a Merry Christmas to everyone. Thank you, and God bless each and every one of you on this special day.
Season's greetings, joyeuse fête. On behalf of all Canadians, as friends and neighbors, I'd like to wish you peace and joy on this holiday season and throughout the new year.
Today, people in Italy, in the United States, and all over the world are joining together in a common celebration of Christmas, thus renewing its perennial message of brotherhood and goodwill.
We are all part of one world, and the coming year may we come closer to living together on it in peace. This is our special wish from Germany. Merry Christmas, fröhliche Weihnachten.
On this joyous occasion of ringing out the old year and ringing in the new, I would like to express, on behalf of the Chinese people, our warmest congratulations and the best wishes to the people of the world.
Happy Christmas to all of you. We are very much looking forward to the idea of greeting Disney and Mickey in France soon. Joyeux Noël.
Hello to everyone all over the world. Ever since the Christmas tradition was first introduced into Japan, it has been widely held custom to enjoy the Christmas spirit throughout our nation. We share your aspiration for peace and prosperity in the world.
What a great parade. We hope that you've enjoyed watching it as much as we have. From my family, Jamie and Lindsay and Sarah and Michael, Merry Christmas, everyone.
Yeah, Merry Christmas, everybody. And for Mickey and Minnie and me, thank you for joining us today. We've had a great time.
And you ever notice by the time that Joan and Michael get all their kids out here, there's no room for us.
Less and less every
year. And we can't forget Kermit, too.
Hi, Kermit.
Thank you to Brendan and Robin behind the camera there. Love you. Merry Christmas to everybody, in fact.
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, brought to you by the Kissimmee-St. Cloud Resort Area, for the best room rates outside the gates of the Walt Disney World Vacation Kingdom. And Premier, the official cruise line of Walt Disney World, with the exclusive cruise and Disney Week. Air transportation for the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade cast provided by Delta Airlines, the official airline of Walt Disney World. Delta loves to fly, and it shows. Talent accommodations provided by the many Walt Disney World Resort hotels. There's only one thing better than visiting the Walt Disney World Resort, staying there. From the Walt Disney World family to yours, this is Dick Tufeld wishing you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. The preceding program was sponsored by the Walt Disney Company.